Hi, this is Presh Talwalkar. Warren Buffett once challenged Bill Gates to a special dice game like the following. The dice each had six faces that were equally likely to show up, but the numbers were different than a standard dice. One of the dice had all threes on all of its six faces. Another one had zero on two of its faces and four on four of its faces. A third dice had an equal number of ones and fives, and a fourth dice had two on four of its faces, and six on two of its faces. So here's how the game works. You and I are each gonna pick a different one of these dice. We're not gonna pick the same ones, we're gonna pick different dice. We're then gonna roll against each other, and the person who rolls the higher number gets a point. We then repeat that many, many times so that the person who rolls the highest number of points over many rolls is gonna win the game. I'm gonna graciously offer you to let you pick your die first. Which one do you want? Give this problem a try, and when you're ready, keep watching the video for the solution. So let's analyze this game. Suppose you pick the dice that has all threes. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pick the dice which has zero on two of its faces and four on four of its faces. What's going to happen when we roll against each other? Well, if I roll a zero, which happens two out of the six times, I'm gonna lose to you because you're always gonna roll a three. However, in the four out of the six times that I roll a four, I'm actually gonna beat you. So I'm going to beat you 2/3 of the time. So if you pick a dice which has all threes, you're gonna lose to me 2/3 of the time. So now suppose you know this strategy and you say, well, why don't I pick the dice that has two zeros and four fours? Well, if you're gonna pick that dice, then I'm going to go ahead and pick the dice which has three ones and three fives. It's a little harder to analyze what happens when we roll these two dice against each other, but it's not too complicated. Now, I'm going to win if I roll a five, because anytime I roll a five, it's higher than you rolling a zero or a four. So in three out of the six cases, I'm going to roll a five and I'm guaranteed to win. Now, when I roll a one, in three out of the six cases, I'm only gonna beat you in the two out of the six cases that you roll a zero as well. So in summary, I'm going to win 3/6 times one when I roll a five, plus 3/6 when I roll a zero, when I roll a one, times 2/6 when you roll a zero. So this nets out to 2/3 of the time I'm going to win. So once again, your die that you pick is gonna lose to my die 2/3 of the time. This argument continues. Let's suppose you pick the die that I just had. Well, in that case, I'm going to pick the next die, which has two on four of its faces and six on two of its faces. We can do a similar calculation. I'm going to win two out of the six times when I roll a six, guaranteed. And I'm also going to win if I roll a two, which is 4/6 of the time, against your one, which happens 3/6 of the time. So once again, I'm going to beat your die 2/3 of the time. Finally, you say, all right, I'll pick the die you just had. And then I'm gonna go ahead and say, well, I'm gonna pick the die that has all threes. Now, I'm going to win whenever you roll a two, which happens 4/6 of the time. So once again, your die is losing to my die 2/3 of the time. So what we've shown is that each die is actually going to lose 2/3 of the time to another die. And this is what's known as non-transitive dice. Each die can be beaten like another, like a game of rock, paper, scissors. This is a cyclical game, and that's why it's non-transitive. The first person who selects the die is always going to be at a disadvantage to someone who picks this second, because each die can be beaten by another. As the story goes, Warren Buffett challenged Bill Gates to this and said, "Go ahead, why don't you select first?" Bill Gates was smart enough to say, "Let me inspect the dice." And he figured out that there was something weird going on with the dice. Did you figure it out? Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. I make videos on math and game theory. You can catch me on my blog, Mind Your Decisions, which you can follow on Facebook, Google+, and Patreon. You can catch me on social media at Presh Talwalkar. And if you like this video, please check out my books. There are links in the video description.